Is this playing separately to the game or is it in-game? It's running in-game. I've essentially converted it to the right format so that it actually runs as in-game music. Right, Engineer UP Extra 25, West of Laramie Subdivision. Dispatcher, our crew change is complete. Okay. You may begin your westward pull from Cheyenne and, subject to signal indications, proceed via track one towards Laramie. Dispatcher, out. We appear to have the turbine on. Still haven't got it working on the controller, so I'm going to use the keyboard. Right, let's get our instructions. Go via Cheyenne Main 1 East, and then we are off to the races, going to Dale Junction. There it is, 35 miles away. Some lights on. Switch over to this side. Put the class light and the number light on. Green light, let's just get accelerated up then. Thought I had a policy of not modifying the game. Yeah, just for content. I don't think anyone really matters about the music. Copper out. There is a tool on UK train sim called DAV Decoder, and it will switch. It'll convert to and from WAVs and DAVs. It says it'll only decode from DAV to WAV, but it actually does it the other way around as well. So if you put a WAV file in as the first one and a DAV file in as the second file name, it will do the conversion. The other thing you can use is just use the blueprint editor. Create a source folder. Create a couple of subfolders, provider, products, and I don't know, audio, and then inside there put the WAV file, and then in Blueprint Editor right click on it and click export. Export this without references, and it will put a DAV file in the equivalent asset folder. It is dead easy. Well, DAV decoder will do the job then if Blueprint Editor won't work for you. Right, we're coming up to the 35 limit. We'll be able to open up in a minute. Yeah, getting the 40 limit soon. Ooh, another 5 miles an hour. We've got the high ball. Couple of them out. You do need a DAV file, but you have to convert the WAV into a DAV file, which, like I say, DAV decoder will do. I think there's a length limit. When I did a 100 meg DAV file, it wouldn't work. This one I'm using at the moment is about 40 meg. So I would suggest keeping it to around sort of the 40 meg mark, which is going to limit you to about 4 or 5 minutes. I'm not doing my whistling. horn, so not that you can really hear the horn. Drowned out by the turbine. There's some windows open. White Mare 84, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. We're behind on our Twitch target tonight. We need to get 2592 to get to keep on our track. Quite a way behind that. Right, 55 mile per hour, we're just passing the limit. Once the train's in, we can speed up. Bogbrush King, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. If you haven't followed, press the follow button. I'm trying to get, see if we can't get some really cool milestones by the time we get to the 1 year anniversary of the show. That's it, Moggy. Get your miniskirt back on. Darkerman, thank you for the follow. Much appreciated. Right, we can speed up a bit. United Terry, fuel consumption on this loco is about three times that of a normal loco, but it uses bunker C oil, or number 6 as it was more recently. Stream Spanspa, I'm going with end of November as being the anniversary of the stream. It's around about that sort of time, it will take a few days. And I'm trying to get 3,500 on Twitch, which is a steep, tall order. 1,000 on Facebook, which should be easy, given the progress we're making so far. And 5,000 on YouTube, which shouldn't be too hard. We're already over a day ahead of schedule on YouTube. Right, maximum power. JW Bobman, how do I do the follow announcer? I think that's Twitch alerts. If you just Google Twitch alerts. Working our way up this hill, we're only doing 43.5. Cheers, Patash. Thanks for the follow. Did UK make a two turbine one? No, this was the most powerful loco they made. This one was 10,000 horsepower with 8,500 horsepower at the rail, which is the most powerful diesel locomotive I think ever on the rails. Single diesel loco. Shri Spanswa, I would like to do a special stream for the annual. I don't know what I'm going to do yet, but we shall see. That would be cool. Start on one. Possibly, once more. I don't know yet. There are lots of ideas. I love the detail on this one. Have I used the new UP box car? No, I haven't. Goodbye, Tyson and Skull. I don't think that works for some reason at the moment. I think that's one of the things they've been working on, because the horn's been recorded in stereo. That's my understanding. What's the mouse? Come back, mouse! Probably should do a flyby. Tuning our way up, 1.2%. I forgot to scream. What does that mean, cop up on now? I forgot to screenshot. I did forget to screenshot, yeah. I'll do another one. Hey, Wen Yen, Will. Truckerman, long train. Yeah, it is. Well, it's actually not that long for an American train, really. Moment that looked like it was coming down on my track. Oops, I should have turned my light off. Apologies! Couple of GP30 pushes on the back. Turbine car. amusing because there's a piddly little 850 horsepower engine in here compared to like every other loco, which is in the thousands. And then you've got this car here, which has the turbine, which is basically like a jet engine on 7.7 encased in a wagon. Instead of being used to propel you along by pushing air up, like, it's being used as a generator to generate electric traction motors. And it can generate, it's a 10,000 horsepower system with 8,500 horsepower to the rail, which is incredible. Rainbow net worth chat. I think a lot of drivers wish they could net worth chat. Even half the people would get there. I'm kidding. Lovely view. Police Gamer 1, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Granite is our next waypoint. How are we doing on the waypoints at the moment? Dunbury, Granite, 6.91 miles. So I haven't changed my back. No, I haven't had the waypoint. I keep forgetting to change that. Driving our way up this hill. Hey there, Missy O'Video Productions, welcome. Haviglock, trying to explain to someone why dumb locos have advanced versions of no controller support. Bottom line is that some developers want to be able to produce fully realistic locomotives, and the controller is very limited or has a very specific control set that it can use. If you can't map the controller the advanced functionality and the levers and switches that you need on the advanced loco, then you either end up in a situation that you can't drive the loco with the simple controls or the HUD, or you have to create a simple version. So rather than about creating an advanced version, it's more about creating the standard version. So they create the advanced version, and that's the one that they use, that's their main one, and then they do a cut down version which is drivable with the Xbox and the HUD. And the reason that that's important is because a lot of people have Xbox and or don't use, or they use the game only with the Xbox or the HUD. It's a lot of people, and therefore if you make a loco that can't be driven by those, then you're cutting your audience probably in half or worse. So by creating a standard loco to go with it, which then can be driven with the HUD and all the Xbox, you're keeping a wide audience. And you've got the advanced version for those that want to get better at it and use the more detailed controls. So that's basically the long and the short of it. Steven Jam doing a YouTube series on creating a route for trains in 2016. I would just build the route and just try and make it to where, you know, each time you do a YouTube video, you focus on a particular bit. And just sort of say, well, here we're going to lay roads. And then you can talk about different kinds of roads. So design the route that you're doing so that you can do... you can sort of say, well, here's how we do crossings, here's how we do level crossings, here's how we do junctions, here's how we get the traffic running on it. So you can cover all the different bits off, but you don't necessarily need to show every last road that you're going to lay on there. But you should do everything three times when you're doing a demo. Try and do everything three times. Even if it's do the first thing, the second thing, do the first thing again, do the third thing, do the second thing, do the first thing, so that you are mixing it up and stuff around a bit. Because if people see things three times, they remember it. JM, I've got a whole new book for tonight. Do another flyby. Truck stop over there. How many times should one test a scenario? Until you've made sure it works. The key thing is to make sure you drive it differently each time you do it, because different people drive scenarios different ways. And to be honest, after a first couple of times, you are then the worst person to test it as the author, because you know what's happening, and therefore you will drive it quite differently. And where did DT get the jet sounds for the turbine? I honestly have no idea. Oh, nice one, Gobbler. I was hoping you'd get that. Master Granite. coming here. Another GP30. Yep, four GP30s. Nice on your reward, Jeff. Enjoy the boxcar. Granite Main 1 now, actually. Still got the high ball, all is good. CalSpec 3, yes, when you buy Train Simulator you get TS16 now, that's just how it works. Mr. Traincow, you should have registered and then you would have got an email. There isn't really anyone else to check. Buford, Maine is our next waypoint. 6 miles to go. And ultimately we're going to Dale, which is in 14. four on, that's pretty cool. Francois, I hit the wrong button when I did Friday's stream. I'd left it on Wednesday's profile when we did the Minecraft stream, so there wasn't a Minecraft one. Our prototype for 377 to leave his last coach behind. Not especially. Good night, Dave. 1.8 to Beaufort. Advantage of it for screenshot purposes. Compress the curve a bit. Well, that's not actually come out too bad. Buford. Cheers, Grand Bomb. Right, cut the power. Back in the cab, watch what we're doing. We're slowing down, we've got a 40 limit just up here. We're now heading for a final waypoint, which is Dale Junction Main 1 East at 7.7 miles. Brakes off. Ron, apologies, I have not had a chance to look at your scenario. Do Silver Streak and movie crash into a station. No, I don't need any. I do need to actually try and crash things. I do enough of that accident. Thank you. Feel free, Ron. Oh, look at that. That's rather nice. Rather a nice view down there. Back up to the speed limit. 5.5 miles to Dale Junction. Feet, highest point on the Transcontinental Railroad. Power down. Because from here on in, it's a braking exercise. Excellent, Jeff. Where did this start? Cheyenne. Running on track 1 to pass a slow moving unit coal train. You will have to stop at Dale Junction Main 1 East for meet. You won't be there for a while, so you should take a quick break. Well, we've got our first sign of the stop signal, got the approach. Can I go inside the cab? Yes, BNSF. Bell's still running. Right, 1.4 miles to go. One point 1 miles. Dale Junction is basically where all three tracks join back up again. Right, there's the waypoint coming up, half a mile away. Where do I get my love for trains from? My father. Same with most people, I think. Well, maybe not my father for most people, but their people's father. Cheers, Stephen Jam, thanks for joining. Right, 4 miles. I need to put some power in there. Almost made it. Cheers, BNSF. Mr. Ovidia Productions. Right, and we're stopped. BNSF, I shall see if I can find a scenario that uses the boxcar. Right, that's completed that scenario. So that was Big Blows Climbing the Divide by Josh Harkness. UP gas turbine on Sherman Hill. Right. That is me done for the evening. And the morning, probably. next show will be tomorrow night. At the usual time. And I will catch you... when will I catch you? I'll catch you tomorrow. Excellent. Thanks very much, everyone, for turning up, and hopefully I'll see you again tomorrow. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye. I can't find the mouse. Oh, there's my mouse. All right, let's try that again. Bye.